how do we go digital? Now that we all know digital is important, not everyone comes from a tech background, right? So if we were to try digital ourselves, how do you really lay the roadmap for a digital strategy? Do we have to rely on a third party who can actually take us for a ride? Can we have another mic, please?
Yeah, there are some specialist service companies for this who can help you take digital. For the first 3 years, I was the digital guy for my company. So I used to create as well as I used to manage social media and stuff. But then the work toll, you know, like, was too heavy. So I had to, you know, like, outsource my digital work to some other company. So what they do is they take care of the brand, the brand's presence on the social media, and all these things. So I think we need not do it by ourselves. We can definitely engage. There are, you know, like hundreds of companies out there, even in Chennai, to do similar services on the digital side.
I think the two parts to this, right? So one is, of course, trying to market your product, and that's one side of it. The other is converting your service itself into a digital service, right? So with the rise of, let's say, paying digitally, or being able to solve your questions digitally, or hailing a cab digitally, everything is digital in that sense. But the idea of user experience, I think, is where a lot of that part of it is kind of missed out, because obviously you have a customer with a certain mental model who is approaching the product with a certain mental model. If you're not able to translate that digitally, that's where it goes wrong the most. So I would definitely recommend strong UX UI practices in every digital change that you're doing. Just shifting it like that, just assuming that it works for one group of people, probably will not work for another group. To give you a quick example, like mobile money is picked up in India much later than it has in Africa, right? And there are probably cultural reasons as to why that has happened. Now, we couldn't have possibly done it earlier, but we did it at the right time probably now. But regardless, to understand who the end user is, understand their mental model is extremely critical, and I think mostly overlooked when in this migration to digital.
Yeah, so two things you have to keep in mind. One is, the first is about the strategy. So who defines the digital strategy? So before you get into digital, you should be clear that is the digital marketing executive going to drive the digital strategy, or you as a business owner who have absolute clarity who will drive the digital strategy? Most often, that's a fundamental flaw that I have been talking to so many SME business owners that I've been listening to. As a business consulting and a digital marketing firm, most questions come in that I have tried digital, it doesn't work, right? Most often founders are comfortable spending the money, I would call it as wasting the money, in the way that traditionally it's used, like typically put a paper ad and stuff like that. Paper ad is typically only about 20 minutes of time, you know, when you have a coffee, that's when you will look at it. Digital, if you do it in the right way, first is strategy. Second, when you talk about Google, I don't go deeper onto the execution transaction model, but just to let you know, how not to do Google AdWords, I can list out 100 things, because we have been doing it day out, day out. There are companies who have worked with other agencies and come back, and when we take a look at it, it's absolutely all crap. There are numerous instances. I have hundreds of examples we personally have been experiencing. So it is not about just putting money on Google AdWords, it's about how to do it right. Like if you give the Merc or a Mustang to a lorry driver, what will happen to your car? So it's not about the guy who's a great driver, I gave him the car, you know what will happen to your piece of the piece of machine that you actually have. So it should be done in the right way. So do the right things, you can actually optimize it better. Number two, results do not come instantly. It can come, of course, something can go viral like the Chuchu, right? Millions of viewers, you know, amazing. The point is, even people who create content do not know which content will go viral. Right, Madhi? There is no secret sauce. You have to keep trying. Likewise, you will need to put in the foundation pretty strong and then build the business on the Google or the Facebook or where your audience is, how you are showcasing, the messaging. Everything matters. If you do things right, you will. I challenge you, you will get the business. There is no way you will actually miss out on the customers that you can grab through digital.
You should talk to Shyam offline. He's given you a guarantee. Just to understand, how many campaigns did you run? So I think
it's a learning experience, actually. Right. It is definitely not a bad experience, because I had a similar experience when I ran a web design company wherein I wanted clients from the US. When I posted on AdWords, immediately I lost all the money. Then I understood that we need to set up timing.
Yes. Right.
US timing, I need to advertise. All my money went away during the Indian, when the Indians were awake. So there's no point, zero value. So you need to, you know, like learn by yourself, you know, like, but you have to experiment with the little money and then learn everything and then pump in a higher amount of money.
Right. For first find out what works and then typically put money on that, right? What? Done. He's very happy with the answer. All right. What's the minimum digital footprint a business should have?
I think you definitely need to be digital, whichever company you are. There are two types here. Whether you want to transform your business into a digital business, or you are a business who are trying to contact, get in touch with your consumers who are in the digital world. There are two types here. So based on your business, you need to take that call. If you are a, say, manufacturing company or you are a construction company, you want to, you know, like connect with the consumers, then you need to be on digital. You need to tell them what you are providing, what is your new project, and blah, blah, everything. Because people are there. You cannot ignore digital. The whole world is on the digital, either in Facebook or YouTube or WhatsApp or WeChat or wherever. You got to reach, consumers through the digital.
Sure. Mathivanan, I'm going to put you in a spot right now. Give me an example of a business which you think can't go digital, and my friend out here will tell you how it can go digital, right? Sorry? Haircut. Sir, it's easy to advertise on Facebook.
Yes.
Mathivanan himself can be a model, I'm sure.
No.
People. No. Haircut. How do you go digital with the salon?
With the salon, right?
With the salon, CK? Just haircuts. Just haircuts.
I mean, actually, I want to agree with one part of this. While we talk about the power of digital, there is a certain value in a human experience, right? Which some products will struggle with. So I think salon is one of those things where end of the day, it's not just about getting the haircut. It's about going to the salon, having that little 30 minutes by yourself, doing something else. So, of course, I can come up with something. But the truth is, there are businesses which are not best, which are interestingly left offline. And just that offline experience becoming important. Of course, marketing it digital, that's a different thing altogether. But as an experience itself, there is certain value in that human-to-human interaction. Just want to say that.
Sure. Any other business other than the haircut? Come on, give me examples of your businesses. Yes, Kripa, go ahead. Sorry? Food? Yeah, food.
So again, this is around marketing or is it around the product itself?
We're talking about marketing, which if your business, when I say going digital, there's no way you can reach customers. Let's keep it to that. Yes, sir, at the back. If I can reach you firstly. Yeah. Wall painting and wallpaper. Now, how to design a digital strategy? I know it's off the cuff, but
so as an interesting example, as to say what we've been seeing in terms of content. So I come from the content space. So recently, I think Saif Ali Khan and a few others were a part of a campaign where basically it's like the lifestyles of the rich and famous. I guess that's the kind of documentary sort of video they had, and you get to see everybody's house, but it's Asian paints throughout. Right? Yeah. Everywhere there's Asian paints and you get to see their houses and Asian paints is plugged in throughout. Right. So there's a brand recall from that, that's one.
Right.
The other, there's a really interesting company called Design Fabric. You should check out their work online. They work with Asian paints as well. So they create a lot of online experiences and they showcase them online through Instagram, etc. And that's sort of a window by which you get to reach out to your end users. I would never watch or like be would never consume anything by Asian paints unless I see it on Instagram or etc. by some leading designers who are using that paint to do some fun artwork, etc.
Sure. I'm not sure if he can hire Saif Ali Khan, Shyam.
Well, I'm available.
What would his digital strategy be like? What would his digital strategy be like as someone who runs a wallpaper furnishings business? What's his digital strategy according to you?
Okay, so one is there are two ways of again looking at it. One, are you taking the business digital or are you leveraging digital, right? So if you're looking at doing business digital, then obviously you need to make your presence felt. People should actually know that you exist, and whosoever is looking for a wallpaper, let's say if it's a freshly built home, people looking for real estate, et cetera, you keep popping up the ads, right? And you keep chasing, you know, there's a remarketing when you keep chasing the, people with ads and stuff like that. That's one. Second, there is another concept called, I'll take a sidestep and then give you an example. There's a Kirana store, right? Kirana stores is another thing they see. I don't need to have a digital presence. I was actually expecting that from the audience. And I'm actually mentoring one company which is actually building an app where, again, morning, I think Harish or somebody said that they place an order from the refrigerator and then the kirana guy, shopwala guy comes and, you know, delivers the goods. The same way, there is an app which is actually built, and they are actually piloting with some apartments where the nearby kirana stores is a typical brick and mortar shop where the orders can get placed and then he delivers and maybe a COD or whatever agreement they have. Now, same way, you can generate sales online, or sorry, you can generate the interests online, make them come to your place if you have a shop or something like that. So you can drive the traffic to your place and make them buy. So you can have an online generation, interest, awareness creation, and then the closure can physically happen at your place, or you can actually take it completely on an online mode and make your brand and presence felt so that goods can be, you know, bought and then supplied online. Only thing is, the end user has to be absolutely comfortable. It depends on different business maturity model. Every business cannot be taken online, right? Initially, when clothing was, you know, in the picture, right, people did not buy. It took some time for them to say, okay, I need to have look and feel of the fabric before I actually wanted to buy. Today, it's very fine. You know, I see, you know, my family, my wife keeps ordering, you know, saris, that, this, everything comes online. And fantastic example is ShopClues, one of the best customer service I have heard from people, that there is no hanky-panky stuff in returning stuff. Instantly they come, pick it up, no questions asked, money refunded instantly, right? So you need to understand the maturity of your customers who can actually buy online. Third, interesting point, you should be able to find those customers online. So all the three has to actually be in sync for your, you know, digital initiative to succeed.
Sure. If you want to add.
One more point is, first, basically try to convince your existing customers, take some good photos and put it online. First, users need to see your work. They need to see what you have done. And then maybe as a next step, you can go into the other things. The first thing is to, you know, like make sure people are able to see your work. So yeah, that is more important as a first step.
So his homework is to make an attractive website to start with.
Yeah, not website, just a Facebook page, which
just
is free.
Just a Facebook page.
And you know, like a nice, you know, like DSLR is too, you know, like cheap these days.
Right.
You can just go around, click some pics, and post it.
So
yeah.
Do you have a Facebook page? How many likes are there on it? What's the engagement right now? 100 will.
Yeah, it's very, nowadays it's very tough to grow Facebook organically,
right,
because unless you are going to pay. Yeah, they are not going to, Facebook is not going to reach even your own fans.
Right.